But I wanted to show you what I plan on using for planning in my 2023 planner. But this is going to be the month of September. I just wanted to show you kind of what to expect for this month and kind of go over how I chose these kits. So I like to have kind of a theme or a color scheme that goes along with a specific month, and then I choose sticker kits to go with that color scheme or theme or whatever. For September, I really like to have kind of like Halloween adjacent or even just straight up Halloween themes because I love Halloween and fall themed sticker kits. So I like to get started with those right away in September. And for this year, I wanted to have kind of like a black and white and brown sort of neutrals color scheme. So that way it isn't just like straight up in your face Halloween. But towards the end of the month, I'm gonna start using a few more kind of like spookier type themes. Maybe not necessarily like very obviously Halloween in terms of like trick-or-treating and dressing up or anything, but definitely spookier, I think. So this is what I'm planning on doing. The order of these sticker kits that I'm gonna be using them, like which sticker kit for which week has yet to be decided. But I'm thinking this is what I'm gonna go with. So for the first week, it's very much not Halloween related or even like spooky whatsoever, just to kind of ease us into this whole theme of the month. So this is a kit called Homebound by Whimsical Plans, and I did get the glitter headers. I can't remember if this came with the glitter headers or if I ordered them separately. It's been a hot minute since I ordered this, so I can't really remember. I think they usually sell their glitter headers separately, but either way, I have the glitter headers. I have these really cute full boxes, so it's kind of like an at-home cozy kind of vibe, which is basically me every day. I work from home and I have like no friends, so I never leave the house. And then we have some deco and some functional icons, some flags, some half boxes, a couple of extra full boxes, some more functional icons, a week list, these little work labels. I don't play Minecraft, but I'm loving this little like chore list thing. And if you've watched my other planner videos, especially this year, you'll know I'm like obsessed with habit trackers. Then we have more of the boxes, labels, some bill dues, and of course, habit trackers. Weekend banner, checklist, some more little icon dots. Oh, a couple different options for the weekend banner. That's fun. I feel like I haven't used a weekend banner in a while, and I haven't seen them being used in this style of planning in a while. I see a lot of people that do the like the more like fancy journaly kind of planning. Do weekend banner sometimes, but maybe I should start doing that again. And then we have little things and some more labels. I love these kind of stickers where they're just solid color strips and you can use them as washi or more little thing stickers. They're so versatile. I love them. Some more boxes, washi, headers, and lists. And then the bottom washi and an extra full box. So there's a lot of black and gray in this kit, and then just like a little bit of brown, which is kind of what I was going for all of these kits. That should be kind of like a running theme. So mostly black and white, maybe a little bit of brown. But even though this is definitely like a cute and cozy themed kit, I think the colors are really going to lend themselves really well to the whole like spooky thing. So I think this is gonna look really good with my other stickers. So we'll see. Next, we have another kit from Whimsical Plans. Honestly, this is one of my favorite shops to get stickers from just because I really like the texture of these stickers and I really like the stickers that come in these kits. Like, I like the layout and everything. I usually have at least one Whimsical Plans kit per month, and if I don't, it is a really weird month for me. But this one is called Goth Princess from Whimsical Plans, and so again, it's not Halloween specific. We're getting a little bit deeper into the whole spooky vibes kind of thing. So it has these full boxes, so kind of fashion, but there's some things like some skulls and spikes and snakes that make it just a little bit edgier. And then here's the deco. I love this sticker with like the rose and the little thorns in the background. And I don't know what inspired this like swirly black ice cream cone with bat wings, but ooh, and we have a double box. I forgot about that. I don't know if I'll use this, but double boxes are always fun. So this should be, I believe, the same kind of layout as the other kit. I'm already forgetting what each of the pages of the other kit looks like, but it should be similar since this is the same shop. Actually, this looks like a little bit different because there is only one weekend banner, and this page looks a little bit different. Or no, maybe it was this one that looked a little bit. Either way, it's fine. It's the same kinds of stickers. Oh, and it looks like this one did for sure come with the glitter headers. Some more of these stickers. So yeah, it's organized just a little bit differently. And it did come with these, what is this? The 15 millimeter or whatever sized washi. I'm really loving this bed in the background with like the moon and the stars and stuff on it. I'm on the lookout for some bed inspiration because my bed set is getting pretty torn up. And then here's the actual full-sized or like thicker bottom washi, extra full box, some date dots. So you see, it's not like Halloween-y, but there's still skulls on it. And to me, that makes it kind of spooky. So I'm thinking this will be week 2 for September. And then now we're getting into kits that are like made for the Halloween season, I think. So this is from Caress Press, and I haven't gotten a Caress Press kit in a while. Ooh, so let's see. There's a lot going on here. It looks like I did get a little like fall themed freebie. Which way? This way. Ooh, this is like orange glittery foil. I don't know if you can see it, but it's not just like straight metallic. There's like little glitter flecks in there. I don't know much about Caress Press foil, so I don't really know what color this is called. That's really pretty. And I'm super basic when it comes to fall, so these definitely apply to me. So I'm sure I'm gonna use these at some point. And then here are some extra full boxes that I assume came with this. Actually, maybe not. Did I buy extra full boxes? I probably should have looked at my orders before I did this, but oh well. We're in it now. It's too late, but these are full boxes that came in the package that I ordered. Whether they were additional cost, I can't remember. But I really like her. Like, this is what I want to look like on Halloween. There's just so much detail in some of these. Like, look at this. There's like a whole lot going on there. So getting into the main kit. These are the premium matte and they're so buttery smooth. They almost feel like glossy. But they're not. Like, they're very much not shiny, like glossy. But you know like how usually the glossy sticker paper and the matte sticker paper usually feel like two completely different things? This, I feel like, is basically the glossy sticker paper. It's just not shiny. But I don't really know that much about paper, so take that with a grain of salt. But here's the deco, and you can see there's definitely a lot more browns in this kit than the others. And it's just so perfect for like the whole theme that I'm trying to go for here. Here's the full boxes. So pretty. I also love this setup. I love a good double box. This is for my 2023 planner where I'm using those Sadie stickers inserts. I've never done like this kind of double full box scene sort of situation in those inserts yet. So I'm really interested to see how that's gonna go. So we have some boxes, labels, and headers. Some more labels, some quarter boxes, some half boxes, some of these like rounded edge quarter boxes. The glitter headers and labels, I guess maybe little things. I don't know. I don't know what all these stickers are called. I'm basically just making it up as I go. Ooh, I forgot about these. So I love these little, like, they're like kiss cut icons in the colors of the kit. That's really nice. And there's 3 habit trackers, which I appreciate. And then this sticker, I never know what to do with it, but I really love it. I want to use it, maybe like work hours or something. And this kit has one of those movie marquees, which I feel like everybody was doing for a while, but I think they're kind of fading out, so it's nice to see. Some more labels or little things, I don't know. And then some like checklist things and some half boxes, some ombre heart checklists. Okay, so we have the bottom washi and the date headers, and I appreciate that there's date dots, although I always get a little bit nervous when the like days of the week are colored and then so are the date dots, because I do like to color block as best as I can, and it kind of bothers me when they don't match. So getting this to match might determine which week I use this kit. But look at this cute little black cat. I love black cats. And this one is just so cute. He looks like he's like trying to beg for food or something. That's adorable. Oh, so this again is Caress Press, and it's the kit Dead and Breakfast. So there's that one. And this is one from Scribble Prints Co. I definitely don't use Scribble Prints Co. that often. Scribble Prints Co. only... Ooh, this is packed really tight. Scribble Prints Co. only does glossy stickers. And I don't usually like to use glossy stickers just because I don't like how they feel like on my fingers. And I don't like how it feels to write on them. And then it really restricts what kind of pen I can use. But I saw this kit and I couldn't pass it up. So this is an Ultimate kit. And it is called Haunted Manor from Scribble Prints Co. So here are the two extra full boxes. Here is another black cat. It's kind of hard to focus on it because this is glossy, so it's being like extra reflective with the lights here. This one looks more of like a grown-up cat and a little less like cute and adorable and a little bit more like sweet. I don't know. And this like old creepy house is awesome. So here are the full boxes. Ooh, I love this deco and some little checklists. And then I don't know what to call these stickers, like week lists, I don't know, and some flags and some like functional shapes, I guess. And then this comes with two of those marquee stickers and then some more kind of creepy full boxes. And then a whole range of sizes and shapes for boxes. I don't know if I've seen these before, like in person for a kit that I've used. Those will be fun to figure out how to use those. Some, I guess these would be considered little thing stickers. Some more boxes. These are all like squared off though. And then some labels. And then boxes and labels that are like patterned. Ooh, I didn't even notice this pattern. It's like hands reaching out of the ground like zombies. Ooh, I don't even know if I looked at this page when I ordered this kit. But I do really love these bottom washi options and then the days of the week. So I think I'm probably gonna use this for the last week of September, like the closest to October, because I think out of all of the kits, this is probably the most Halloween-ish. So I'll wait the longest to use this one. And then for the monthly kit, this is going to be really interesting, so we'll see how this goes. I've done it once before, though. I saw this kit, and I think this might have been what inspired the theme for this month, and it has really similar artwork to that last Scribble Prints Co. kit, or at least kind of a similar theme, in my opinion. But this was designed for October, so I'm going to have to figure out a way to cover up the October writing here. But I have a few sets of script stickers for the months, so I'm hoping I can cover that up okay. But this is the kit Ghost Manor from Kimmy Studio. Unfortunately, Kimmy Studio is no longer open. They were my all-time favorite shop to get monthly kits from, and they are now closed. So, but when they were going out of business, I bought as many monthly kits as I could to carry me on for as long as possible, because I think that this is where I got like a majority of my monthly kits from, and I don't really know what I'm gonna do without them. But that is a problem for future Lisa. So it comes with this sidebar with like checklist things. Back when the shop was operational, you could choose between the checklist sidebar or like a stack of bill due type sticker things. And I usually went with the bills, but I think this is the only one that they had left because I was buying this in like an everything must go kind of situation. These are going to go across the top. So this is going to go across the top of the left page. So Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, And this is going to go across the top of the right page, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. And then these are, you can't really see them cut, but these are individual boxes, and they're cut to the size of the monthly boxes, which I'm hoping fit in the Sadie stickers inserts. We'll see. But these are cut to fit inside the Happy Planner monthly boxes. And then there's just some like functional doodles down at the bottom, and then some more boxes, but these ones have kind of an overlay to them, so you can write a little bit more easily on these. And then we have the payday date flags, some little scripts, some little skinny washi strips, and then some more like icon dots. And then here are the bills and some boxes. So monthly kits are usually a lot smaller than the weekly kits. So stay tuned to see how this is gonna go. First of all, because I'm going to be using this in September, and this is technically an October kit, and I'm not sure whether or not these boxes will fit. I think they should, but we'll see. And then I do like getting these like notes pages kits with how the 2023 planner is set up. I'm not 100% sure how I'm going to use this yet. I know that I'm going to use it, I just don't know where and on which pages. So this one probably deviated the most from the color scheme that I was going for this month. Not a lot of people put stickers on those notes pages or like the overview pages, or at least use a full kit for them. And so there's a lot fewer options out there. And so this is the closest that I could find to matching the current color scheme. And it's fine. I mean, this page will be kind of separated probably, so it's not the worst thing in the world. But this is from Caffeinated Kate, which is one of the few shops that I can ever find that have stickers like this, these like lined boxes. And then there's a few different options to choose from for like this large horizontal box, but I get the little like monthly habit tracker because, hello, it's me. I'm never going to say no to a habit tracker. And so the idea is that you put it on the page kind of like this, and then your whole page is covered in stickers. And then that's either at the very beginning or the very end of the month to kind of like recap or plan ahead or something. And then there's some extra little like flags and stuff that you can use functionally. And then some like washi strips and then check boxes and all that good stuff. And then if you've watched my Plan With Me videos before, you'll know that I usually like to line the binding of each page and washi. And so this is the washi that I'm planning on using for this month. I honestly can't remember when or where I got this. I just found it in my little like box of washi. I had no idea that I had this. So I don't know if that means that this is really old or if it's really new. Someone's D-stash, I don't know. But it's like these little flying keys from Harry Potter. I feel like there was a special name for these, but I can't remember what they're called. But I thought it was perfect because it goes really well with the color scheme. Oh my gosh, I am Minerva. Actually, Minnie, you kind of match my stickers for this month. That's nice. So when you get your fur all over the place, it'll at least match. Okay, well, I don't think I'm getting rid of her. But this is as far to the side as I've been able to get her, so we're just gonna deal. But anyway, like I was saying, Harry Potter and an old spooky castle and bad things are always happening, which is basically exactly what I was going for this month. So perfect tape. Plus it's not like super in your face Harry Potter, but like if you know, you know, you know? So I guess now is as good a time as any to get the washi put down. Where's September? All these months that I haven't done yet. This planner looks a little weird right now because these pages eventually are going to get pasted together, but let's pull out the actual inserts. Ooh. And these are my Sadie's stickers inserts. Let's get that washi on there. So this is the monthly, and I'm not sure, should I put washi on the side? All right, let's do this one at a time. All right, so I didn't think about this until I was like basically almost done, but the punch that I have is a Happy Planner punch, but the Sadie Stickers punches are a little bit different, so I'm not sure how this is gonna go. Let me see. Maybe I'll take this off so I can guide up holes on the bottom. So let's see. Let's line this up and see how much. I don't know how much you can see on camera, but this is pushed all the way back and you can see like the white on the top of the little hole punches. That's because the Sadie Stickers punches just don't go as like deep into the paper. So I should have thought this through a little bit more before I did this, but that's okay. Okay. Not too bad. I was a little bit off, I think, maybe. Overall, not the worst I could have done. Okay. Oh my gosh. Okay. This part's done. And the holes are a little messy, but it's good enough. I'm putting them back onto the discs. Okay, so this is everything. I really like how it looks all together. Again, this like little note section, it has some of the right colors. It's not a perfect match, but that's okay. The page that I'm gonna be putting this on is going to be a page where I'm probably going to be pulling in a lot of leftover deco from the rest of these kits. So hopefully I can make it work, but it's honestly not as bad as I thought it was gonna be, other than like if I hide this huge chunk of like red and green, it's not too terrible. Overall, I'm really, really excited to see how this looks. If you are also interested in seeing how it's all going to look in my planner, definitely make sure that you stay tuned to my channel. Subscribe if you haven't already. Bye!